Hey everybody, what is going on? It is Jet Saber, and I am here with my comparison of the Blue Snowball Ice and the Audio-Technica ATR-2500. Now, the Audio-Technica I am currently recording with right now, so I'm going to try not to move it so much so it doesn't have too much bumping, and because I don't have a shock mount for it, and neither do I have a stand, because I, as you guys saw on my Twitter feed, I did break that. So we're going to start with the Blue Snowball Ice here. It has a really nice hard finish, and this thing is a rock solid mic for those people trying to start out on YouTube. I've used this for about 2 years on my old YouTube channel, and I love this mic. The audio quality of the two aren't very different, but I gotta say the Audio-Technica has a really, 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 really nice, crisp, clean cut audio. So here's the Blue Snowball. Here's it up close. It has the blue sign on the front there. This thing is virtually invincible. It's really hard, really sturdy. Both of these mics do come with three-legged tripod stand that you can put them on. They're pretty cheap, and I've already broken both of them. It's probably my fault, but who knows. So next, let's check out the Audio-Technica. So here it is. I'm gonna try to be really, really gentle with this thing, because I do not want my audio and my video to be that messed up, for that matter. See, it has a blue LED at the front that notifies you that it is turned on. It has a headphone jack, so you can plug your headphones in and hear your audio directly after you record it. And you can actually change the volume of your computer with the microphone hands-on. So the Blue Snowball Ice has no buttons on it, because it's not the Blue Snowball. This is the Ice version. Make sure you guys know that when you're buying it. That was the Ice version, and this doesn't have any controls other than the volume settings, and it has a headphone jack with it. And it comes with another, this is actually the USB cord for the Blue. I actually used this one because the one that came with the Audio-Technica was really, really cheap, and it kept falling out of my Audio-Technica. So, as you can see, a very sturdy design here. This thing's actually pretty heavy, just about as heavy as the Blue. Actually, maybe a little less, but it's pretty sturdy. It may not look pretty sturdy, but it actually is pretty heavy, and it's also pretty rock solid, so you'll probably have a hard time breaking this, or your kids might. So I'm going to do a test of how well these two microphones fare when you're doing your commentary. I'm going to do them in the same program, Audacity, and I'll see you guys then. Let's go. So to start off the test, I'm going to begin with the Audio-Technica ATR-2500. I do have a pop filter on it. So this is the audio quality of it, and we're going to hear the Blue next. I did find that the Audio-Technica does have a slightly more crisp audio quality, and I do find it to be better, which is why I use it for my commentary. So to finish off this video, I'm going to end out with the test of the Blue. Now, I find that the Blue is really, really a decent mic for people that are trying to start out on YouTube. But the Audio-Technica is around $70, and the Blue Snowball Ice is around $40-$50, I think, on Amazon right now. So have your pick. The audio quality honestly isn't that different to me. But if you want the Audio-Technica and you got a couple extra bucks, then definitely get it. You want the Blue and you don't have as much and you're on a lower budget, then definitely get that too. Get that instead. Thank you guys so much for watching this video. And tell me what you guys think in the comments of these two mics, and I'll see you guys next time. Peace.